My name is Jesper Kronborg Jensen, and I'm Assistant Professor at the University of Southern Denmark.
My name is Kristin Balslev Munksgaard, and I'm Associate Professor at University of Southern Denmark.
My name is Jan Stenstrup Albjørn, and I'm Professor in Supply Chain Management at the University of Southern Denmark.
Today, modern supply chain stands at the forefront of major environmental challenges in the coming decades, especially food supply chains. So, given the scale of these future challenges, the need for green technological and managerial innovations are often highlighted in the literature. So what we wanted to investigate was how can green supply chain innovation actually enhance value offerings along the supply chain, thereby supporting both economic growth and but also decreasing environmental impacts at the same time. So our method is actually based on, we started by selecting a specific technology, bioenergy technology, giving its fit with the food supply chain as an example of a green innovation. And then we analyzed how implementation of this green practice or green innovation actually can enhance value offerings along the food supply chain. The analysis part of the paper we divided into four aspects. First, we try to establish an overview of the existing actors in the food supply chain. Then we outlined the current state of the supply chain, including the product, byproduct, and waste flows. And then we explained how this specific green innovation in terms of bioenergy actually affects these supply chain flows. Finally, by comparing part two and part three, we discuss how green supply chain innovation can then enhance value offerings. In this picture, the current supply chain is illustrated. As we can see, the supply chain comprises the four main actors in the food supply chain that we analyzed, and this is a farmer, a milling company, a bakery, and a retailer. In the food supply chain, two primary flows are depicted. That is the primary forward product flow, where it goes from grain to flour to bread until the retailer. And then we have the waste flow, and here we can see that the supply chain actually is partially closed because some of the waste flows already goes to animal feed, whereas others end in landfill. However, by introducing the biogas energy technology, we can now utilize not only the byproducts from the retail stage, but also from the baking and the milling stages.
So now we turn to part four of the analysis, where we are going to look at how this green supply chain innovation can enhance value offerings. And what we see in the current perception is that the companies, they share a common interest in sustainability, but they very much work on their own to actually achieve this. And they very much focus on minimizing cost of handling waste. So the value created and captured is very much related to profit. But then, if we look at triggering for this supply chain innovation, we see a new future where the companies start using biogas technology, which leads to new processes and a new structure in the supply chain. Then we see a creation of a reverse flow in the supply chain, where we see new possibilities for value creation and value capturing. And we see the retailer as well as the bakery that are giving new branding opportunities. And the farmer who is reaching a better fertilizer, replacing the old mineral fertilizer. We also see how exchange value is shifting. We still have a focus on price and minimizing cost, but what is more important is that the companies is also experiencing how they get new profit by selling waste. So in this sense, what is waste for one company becomes a commodity of value that can be used by another company. So where we in the current perception have a primary profit-oriented value capturing, we now have profit as well as a greater green image for the companies and also a wider societal value in form of environmental benefits. And in this supply chain, the new future, we see a more cradle-to-cradle perspective used. And what is also very important here is that the companies are very much collaboration-oriented for this to actually happen.